Now the Philippine benchmark index returns to the 6,500 level, closing today's trade at 6,519. Value turnover was at 2.8 billion pesos. Now tomorrow is the last trading day for the year. Let's look at the highs and lows of the Philippine market this year and maybe get some tips from Regina Capital Development Corp's Luis Limlingan on how to position for stocks in 2024. Luis joins us today on the Business Roadshow. Hello, Luis. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas and advance Happy New Year, Stan. Thank you for having me.
Happy New Year to you, too. Now, it looks like the PSEI is ending a bit lower than last year's, or maybe even flattish. All things considered, was this a good performance? I mean, could we have achieved better last year or this year, 2023, given all of the challenges we've been through? Could it have been worse as well?
Well, as a whole, the index, as you said, was lower to flattish. If you had made the right bets, especially in the clear winners, for example, then I think you would have been better off. And if you had been overweight on those that underperformed, then same result. Now, I think everyone was hoping that we would be spared from the weakness, especially with the high interest rate environment. And I think with a lot of geopolitical tensions, or sudden geopolitical tensions, this couldn't be avoided. So given the scenario, it's still quite fortunate that we're still able to close at this level.
All right, Luis, what made investors busy today? We ended at 6,500, above it, 6,519. Looks like we didn't sustain yesterday's close to 4 billion worth of participation, though. It's just about 2.8 today, or less than 3 billion. What were investors busy about trading the second to the last day of the year?
I'm not sure if busy is the right word, but I think they're just positioning ahead of next year. Probably those who showed a positive return already in their portfolio are already cleaning up. We saw this was already evident towards pre-close. So I think that's all they're doing right now. Probably they have another round tomorrow, or it's a final round tomorrow. So we might expect more of the same. I hope the value turnover does pick up, because I think maybe they were waiting for better price levels, and that's why we saw that the volume turnover was rather anemic.
And also the quality of the value turnover. We're really hoping that the foreign funds will come in, at least for posterity even. Now, November net inflows, speaking of inflows, 673 million, a sign of foreign investments trickling in at least in the last 2 months. We know how important foreign funds are to prop the markets now. What could they be waiting for still?
Well, I would think they are just waiting for cues from the Fed, given that they've already made projections on the direction of interest rates. Now, the other thing probably is not really that they're waiting for a cue, but perhaps, and this is my guess, is that at the beginning of the year, they assumed rates would be at their peak, or rather during, or when they assumed that it reached their peak, they locked in into fixed income. Now, as they gradually reach their maturities, they're going to unwind these positions and probably make placements. Now, I hope when that time comes, they will see the Philippine market as a great opportunity to buy into a different asset class as opposed to the fixed income. So that's what I'm actually hoping for.
All right. Still on looking back at the trading year, which issues do you see were the clear winners and the worst performers, even at least for the index?
Well, if you just look at the performance of the index, I think year-to-date, if I'm not mistaken, the top performer is Meralco.
Okay.
And Convergys was the laggard. And I think a lot were betting on banking, given the high interest rate environment. So I think at a certain point, the banks like BDO and BPI did outperform. But right now, I think the assumption is it's going to be neutral moving into 2024, and that's why we saw that the price did weaken. But in terms of power, they think that the supply constraints will continue for the medium term, And that's why probably they're still weighing heavily on Meralcan. That's why it's still performing. So it's a combination of the performance this year and forward looking into 2024.
All right, speaking forward looking to 2024, now some optimism seen next year with the Fed hinting some cuts. Do you feel the same optimism with our own BSP? I mean, are we likely to mirror Fed cuts, or do we have local concerns that could push policy higher for longer?
I'd like to think that we are one data dependent, meaning if inflation is controlled within the acceptable range of the PSP, meaning 2 to 4%. In fact, I think they want more leeway, which is closer to the lower end of the band of 2%. Then we're going to see, obviously, we're going to see that rates will be cut. The second thing is also the Fed. If they don't follow or keep in line with the Fed, this usually hurts the peso. So they're also aware of that. And of course, a weaker peso is also going to hurt import costs as well. So that's going to keep tight. But I think they don't want to be too aggressive as well, because they understand that since there are a lot of OFWs who send their hardworking money back, a peso that is, you know, relatively, I think, you know, higher, it's better for OFWs. So that's why I think we saw that at around 55, right? I think it was trading at that range. But we noted at 57, there was a lot of defense in terms of buying into the local currency.
Okay, Luis, equities also seem to recover next year. Are you advising now your clients to review their portfolios, increase exposure in stocks right now as against fixed income, as opposed, of course, to the mix that a lot of investors had in 2023 when really the stock market wasn't doing well and the bond yields were higher?
Well, you know, I am you're asking someone who works in this industry, of course, I'd say it would be much better coming into next year. I think, obviously, the participation equities will be stronger. Okay. Again, I didn't notice in the beginning of the year a lot of the funds that we were talking to said that they're going to be concentrating in fixed income, and obviously so. But now they're going to be looking for, again, different another asset class, and hopefully equities will be that one. Mm-hmm. In terms of investing, in terms of advising clients, we normally say not just to be a bit cautious during December and January. Traditionally, everyone knows about the Christmas rally, and there's some optimism heading into January. Noticeably, it's during the end of the first quarter that we might see some profit taking. So we tell them, don't be in a rush. It's still a seller's market generally. I would think, wait for the volume to come in. Right now, as you noted, I think we only did around 2.5 billion.
Yeah.
So that price is able to be easily influenced, no? Given very few participants. But if you see the volume pick up to historical levels, 8, even 10 billion, that means all the, you know, foreign funds are back into the market. And that means I think you have to start positioning.
Right
now, I think you shouldn't be rushing at this point.
All right. So it looks like 2024 is a better year than 2023, but still cautious optimism is the tone. Luis Limlingan of Regina Capital Development Corporation, thank you so much for joining us today. Happy New Year to you.
Thank you very much. Happy New Year.